Timmy, always good to see you. Thanks for your time. Tell us what brings you back home.
Yeah, you know, throughout the season, I pick these dates, you know, and I strategically pick the places I go to. I think for me, coming to a place like Central Coast is, you know, a sentimental feel to the area. You know, the kids, you know, want to be inspired by footballers, and for myself, it's nice to give them a lift. You know, the numbers are not massive like Sydney and Melbourne, where you've got your superstars, but I want to make sure that I also touch the kids here, you know, make sure that they feel wanted. But, you know, just teaching fundamental skills, participation and interaction with me that, you know, no one else will ever get. And, you know, it's been pretty special, and it makes me very proud because I've got kids myself, and, you know, I like to know that the parents are spending their money well as well.
And of course, aside from the coaching of the kids and the specific skills and so on, I noticed that you take time out from the program to talk to them as a group and really inspire them. Tell us about some of the key messages that you give them.
The one thing is that I always say to kids, you know, not that I got bullied, but I got put down a lot as a kid, you know, and trying to make them understand that I wasn't the greatest footballer. I wasn't massive, and I, you know, basically had time to develop. And people told me I was too small, I was never going to make it. Everyone teaches kids, you know, the great stuff and how brilliant it is, but the mental side of letting them know that, you know, they've got somewhere to turn to. I'm trying to make them turn that into something constructive, thinking positively and saying, hey, Tim Cahill got bullied, but look at him now, you know? They get to ask me anything, you know, and they ask me some real personal questions, and that's my time with them, 1 hour of me showing them my clips of my family, my personal life, and, you know, letting them understand that they need to do their homework, that they need to say please and thank you to their mum and dad, because they said, oh, who's your inspiration? I said, my mum and dad, and they went, oh, what about, you know, Pele, what about, yeah, too, but my parents sacrificed a lot. So straight away, I stood the kids up in a row and I said, you've got the best kit, you've got everything. And I said, it costs a lot of money. Your parents take you to training every day, and you need to be thankful. You need to go home and say thank you to your parents. And the parents have come back to me and said, look, the kids are just, you know, they're just different. And I said, you know, half my battle was my attitude, the way I asserted myself around people and the presence that I left, and being humble. And the rest of it was heart and passion and training hard.
I don't think I've ever told you, but I go around the primary schools in Australia quite often, right, and do a talk to them about football, try and inspire them to play the game. But I talk to them about the great champions. One of those is you and some of the other really prominent guys. But about you, I talk to them about when you were in those early teenage years, yeah, and it was tough for you,
yeah,
right? And, you know, you didn't make some of those rep squads, right? Yeah. And every kid these days thinks, well, if I don't make the under-12s, I don't make the under-13s, yeah, it's not going to happen for me. Yeah. So out of your career, isn't one of the great messages, certainly, that I give them is, mate, that you never, ever give up, regardless what happens?
You've been there and done it, Fozzie, and you know how difficult it is because, you know, it's nice for us to have opinions, but we've done it. You know, we've played at the highest level and we've been overseas and we've seen the sacrifices we've had to make. So you've got to put it in layman's terms to kids. You've got to let them understand that you know, I wasn't strong enough, wasn't fast enough, but I trained every day hard. And if I never was going to be a footballer, you know, I'm happy. You know, I'll go be a physio or I'll study to be a chef. But that's the thing, and I show kids here, you know, there might be a few kids that are, you know, a bit more elite than the other. I pull one aside and I just say to him, don't worry about it. I said, I'll go through the motions with you and, you know, ask me questions on my website. And, you know, the whole thing is, Fozzie, is to make sure they feel wanted. You know, and this is a category for me, there is no elitism. It's participation and fundamental skills. I teach ladders and hurdles, and I've got Robbie Anderson here that we derive a program that basically I use with Everton before every big warm-up, ladders, hurdles, the cones, and then we do little ball skills, we do passing, we do shooting, we finish with the World Cup. That's my session every day in the Premier League. And people saying, you know, how can you do it with the kids? Of course you can do it with kids, but just make it fun, you know? So, no, it's a massive privilege to be used in schools with kids and to be used that way. But the one thing is, I always say is, I started with nothing, I ended up with everything, and I'm still the same person.
Let's turn now to the season just gone. You talked about, you know, being bullied as a kid. Why were you bullying that guy on the pitch a few weeks ago?
Yeah, I think, you know, he made a statement pretty soon after it happened. And Alan Pardew spoke to me, and he's a gentleman. And the thing is, in life, like I explained to the kids, they asked me the question yesterday. I said, I have to learn from that. And I have to make sure that you guys understand that, you know, if Tim Cahill does something out of character, I want you to look at it and say, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to try and make things better. And that was the time I got the personal time with them to explain to them exactly what happened. And, right. You know, things are said that shouldn't be said. And I'm man enough to accept the three-match ban.
Finished seventh in the Premier League. Really another outstanding season for Everton and particularly for David Moyes. How do you reflect back on it now?
Mate, it's been fantastic. Personally for me, yeah, you love to score loads of goals. But, you know, I've played a majority of every single game. I've played in all the biggest games and I've been used maybe in a different role and I've been attacking, I've been defending. But, you know, when you become 32 and I've been at the club for 8 years, you basically have to help the team. Whether you play 45 minutes, 60 minutes, 5 minutes, it's about a squad. It's about a unit that try and finish above Liverpool, that try and get to an FA Cup semi-final and final. And, you know, I've learned a hell of a lot. I've matured and the manager's fantastic with me. You know, some games I get rested and some games I play. And, you know, now I understand what a complete footballer has to do. And that is to play for the team all the time. So, you know, we finished in a great position. I played a majority of the games and, do you know what? I feel really fit. You know, the next 4 years I'm targeting 30, 35 games a season, and you know, my fitness has been outstanding. So, you know, I'm pretty proud. And now to cap it off, I want to have a good couple of clinics here, get some training done with the kids, and then you know, head off to Denmark and then see what we can do. Because to be totally honest with you, I think this is going to be the biggest test as a national team. I think people need to really understand, yeah, we've got a great squad. Defensively, we could be a lot better. Attackingly, getting Bresciano back is going to be fantastic. But I don't like to get carried away because the Asian group's one of the hardest. And also, you know, we're an okay team. We're not unbelievable. And we need to make sure that we know that because there's going to be some tough games. But I think we'll see what's going to happen in the next couple of games. And hopefully we can ride the wave and do something special.
And so physically, you're feeling fine at the end of the season? Because now, of course, you're going into the real heat over in Oman. There's a lot of concerns about the time playing and all that.
Well, this is all part of preparation. Do you know what I mean? Come to the Central Coast, prepare for the... Nah, mate, I can't wait. You know, to join camp, I met with Holger. He came and watched the Man U 4-4 draw that potentially, you know, wrecked the league for Man United. But we spent a great 2 hours after and we text and we have a chat to each other throughout the season. And this is the thing, my relationship with the manager is the same as Moyes's. I've got a lot of respect for the man and what he has to do. He has to travel around the world and watch us, and he has to make decisions and he has to drop players. And like I said to him, the same with my manager, whether I play 45 minutes, 5 minutes or 90 minutes, I've got his back, and that's all he needs to know. And we shook hands, give him a hug, and we're going to go away and try and qualify for a World Cup.
Well, mate, everyone here, Timmy, knows that whether you play 5 minutes or 90, yeah, when it comes to Australia, you give everything as you've always done. Thanks for your time, buddy.
Thanks for having me, mate.